This tiny teach is about clonal selection and activation of B cells. Before exposure to an antigen, you have one B cell that has a B cell receptor that's able to recognize and bind to that particular antigen. And the antigen itself will select the appropriate B cell by binding to the B cell receptor. And once the antigen selects the B cell and binds to the B cell receptor, it stimulates that B cell to divide by mitosis to produce a bunch of clones, identical B cells. So here in our picture, we have a bunch of different B cells. Each one of them has a unique B cell receptor. Our antigen is going to select whichever of these B cells that has the correct receptor for the antigen to bind into. So in this case, this antigen selects this B cell because the antigen fits into the B cell receptor. That antigen selecting the B cell by binding to its B cell receptor will stimulate this B cell to divide by mitosis to produce clones. What we end up with is a bunch of B cells that are identical to the one that was selected. The majority of the B cell clones become plasma cells. Plasma cells function for about 4 or 5 days, and they secrete antibodies that can bind to this particular antigen. So here are the antibodies that are produced, and antibodies have antigen binding sites at the tips of them. This antigen can fit into one of these antigen binding sites. These antibodies will circulate in the blood, the body fluids like mucus, colostrum, breast milk, and lymph, and these antibodies will go in search of their antigen. When the antigen binds to the antibody, it tags the antigen for destruction by the immune system. The rest of the B cell clones become memory cells. These memory B cells are very long-lived, and they stay behind in case the same antigen is encountered again. Specific immunity happens faster the second in any additional times we encounter the same antigen again. Part of that is because of memory cells. All of these B memory cells have the same B cell receptor. So when this antigen comes in again, there's a lot more of these memory B cells. The antigen is going to bind to these B cell receptors, and that's going to stimulate the memory cells to divide by mitosis to produce clones. They're going to make more memory cells, and they're going to also make more plasma cells, which are going to secrete antibody against the antigen.